Hello, everyone. Today, I'm going to show you an incredible trick, transforming a few common household items that you might otherwise discard into a surprisingly versatile tool. I'm starting with a standard tire valve stem. My first step is to carefully cut away the rubber surrounding the valve using a pair of scissors. This allows me to isolate the metal valve component, which is the part we'll be modifying. I'm disassembling the metal valve stem. I'm removing the inner core and any washers or nuts that are part of the original assembly. This leaves us with the main brass tube and its retaining nut, which are crucial for our project. I'm taking a simple metal fork. This will serve as the base for our new tool. I'll mark two branches here because these are the ones I'll be reshaping. Using a pair of pliers, I'm carefully bending the two tines of the fork inwards. I will break the two inner prongs, creating a wider gap. This modification is essential to accommodate the metal valve stem component we'll be adding and to ensure proper alignment. Leave a comment and let me know which country you are watching from. It's great that we can connect and chat from all over the world. With the fork prepared, I'm now taking a couple of metal washers. I'll place these on the middle tines of the fork. They will help secure our valve stem firmly in place. I'm inserting the main body of the tire valve stem between the middle tines of the fork, making sure the washers are on either side. This will be the housing for our heating element. I'm using pliers to carefully tighten the entire assembly, ensuring the valve stem is held very firmly by the fork tines and washers. A tight connection here is key for stability and functionality. Now, for another component, an old AA battery. This battery holds a secret ingredient for our project. I'm carefully removing the outer metal casing from the battery using pliers. I'm doing this to extract the carbon rod from the center. This rod is an excellent conductor and will be our heating element. If you find this video interesting, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any interesting ideas coming soon. After removing the casing, I'm gently wiping down the carbon rod with a piece of tissue. This helps remove any residue or electrolyte, ensuring a cleaner and more efficient heating element. I'm inserting one end of the carbon rod into the chuck of an electric drill. This allows us to easily shape it. I'm using sandpaper to sharpen one end of the carbon rod into a fine point while the drill spins it. This sharp point will concentrate the heat, making our tool highly effective for precise work. Look at that sharp point. It's perfect for our needs. Next, I'm carefully inserting the sharpened carbon rod into the brass tube of the tire valve that's secured in our fork. This creates a compact and ready-to-use heating probe. Now, we need to create the electrical connections. I'm taking a length of red electrical wire. I'm stripping a small section of insulation from one end of the red wire. This exposes the conductive copper strands, which are essential for completing our circuit. I'm wrapping one stripped end of the red wire tightly around one of the outer tines of the fork. This ensures a complete circuit across the tines and ultimately through our carbon rod. To prevent any accidental short circuits and for added safety, I'm wrapping electrical tape securely around the exposed wire sections and along the handle of the fork. This insulates the connections and makes the tool safer to handle. I'm stripping the free end of our red wire and securing it to the red alligator clip. To easily connect our tool to a power source, I'm using alligator clips. This will be for the positive terminal of our power supply. I'm repeating the process with a blue wire and a blue alligator clip. This will serve as our negative connection. I'm connecting the red and blue alligator clips to the terminals of a powerful battery. You can see how the battery has a lot of power ready to go. I'm placing two razor blades on a piece of wood. This will be our first test material to see the power of our new tool. Watch closely as I touch the sharpened carbon rod to the razor blade. See how it instantly heats up and melts through the metal. The concentrated energy at the tip of the carbon rod generates intense heat, making it an effective cutter for thin metal or plastic. Look at that! It melted right through the razor blade. This is proof of the incredible heat our simple tool can generate. Let's try another demonstration. I'm taking two lengths of blue electrical wire. I'll strip the ends of both wires, exposing the copper strands. Then I'm twisting them together, creating a point where we can observe the heating effect again. Now, I'm applying the heated carbon rod to the twisted wires. Immediately, you can see the wires glowing and melting together. This demonstrates its effectiveness as a quick soldering or joining tool. The wires are now fused, showcasing the tool's ability to join materials with ease. It's surprisingly powerful for such a simple construction. For our final test, I'm taking a metal bolt and a nut. We'll see how our DIY tool handles a larger, thicker piece of metal. You can see it glowing red hot almost instantly. This incredible heat transfer demonstrates that this tool can be used for various applications, like loosening rusted nuts or for metalworking projects requiring localized heating. And there you have it, our incredible multifunctional heating tool made from a few simple repurposed items. This DIY device proves that with a little creativity and ingenuity, you can achieve amazing things and solve everyday problems. If you enjoyed this project and found it inspiring, please give this video a big thumbs up, share it with your friends, and leave a comment below telling me what other unexpected tools you'd like to see me create. Don't forget to subscribe for more fantastic DIY ideas. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.